So, you asked for an example of the difference between contrast coding and dummy coding?
Yes.
So, let's get going with that. I have got, from the novel idea submission, I know that house type comes in at least four categories based on one of the groups. I know that my options for house type are townhouse, duplex, single family, and conversion. I assume that there's others like condo and so on. In order to dummy code this, I would have townhouse 1000, duplex 0100, single family 0010.
It's almost like
one hot encoding.
Yeah.
There's just one fewer column for it.
Okay.
There's one fewer column because you don't actually need all of the columns to get all of the different options represented. You can uniquely identify any of these given these three. So, is something a townhouse? Well, if it's a one in townhouse, zero everything else, then it's a townhouse. Is it a duplex? If it's one in duplex, zero in everything else. Is it conversion? If it's zero in everything.
Yep, that makes sense.
So that would wind up giving you, in your model, the beta weight on townhouse would be how much better is a townhouse than the average of the others? How much better is a duplex than the average of the others? There is no way to ask the question of how much better is a conversion than the others, because there's never something where I'm actually looking at the value for conversion.
Okay.
Because the weight would always multiply at zero.
Yeah.
Or so it's, when all of these are nothing, that's what your conversion is going to be. So that's what we're going to have for dummy coding. I'm not trying to grab my Google, I just want to. Compare that with contrast coding. So for contrast coding, we're going to need things that add up. Should not just start with that. We're going to need things that add up to zero. And we can do that in a few ways. I will apply some real-world knowledge to know how many people live in it. So my first category is going to be single fam. It's going to be multifam. So multifamily home is a home that has more than one family living in it. Our big options for that are a conversion, which used to be a single family home, but now more than one family lives in, and a duplex, which always intended to have two people or two families living in. I am then going to put the same number in the rest of them so that they add up to zero. It's not always going to be the same number, but this satisfies our contrast coding right now. And what this means is that our beta weight on here, so on multifamily, is going to tell us how much more a house costs if it is either a duplex or a conversion, or the average of duplexes and conversions, compared to the average of single families and townhomes. So, I've got this. Let's look for the next one. I'll call it freestanding. So, a townhouse, a duplex, and a conversion. All, I have multiple families living in the same physical building. A single family home just has one family, and then there's like a yard or something before you reach the next ones.
Yeah.
So I will want three minus one, minus one, minus one.
Okay.
Because that will tell me, is being freestanding better than the average of the other three groups? The last one is going to be make the math work. And the exact process for this is a little wonky. I would just, like, in reality, I would just plug this into a tool.
Okay.
Because the two rules for contrast coding are, like, the first rule is this all has to add up to zero, but it's also for every pair of rows, add their sums across this to zero. They have sums here, add the sum of those to zero.
Okay.
So there's a last one to make sure each one is uniquely identifiable. It tends not to mean as much. And there are tools out there that will calculate them for you.
Okay.
Like off the top of my head, you know, actually now that I look at it, this is not strictly speaking a contrast code because it does not satisfy it for this pair. Because this is 0, 0, 0, and this is 2. 2 is greater. 2 is not equal to 0. So, strictly speaking, this is not contrast coding the way it would be in statistics. The point I'm trying to get across here is instead of doing one-hot encoding or dummy coding or something, you make meaningful group comparisons.
Yeah.
And with those meaningful group comparisons, you can interpret the beta weights to mean something you care about. That's what we're really trying to get out of these. It's not that we are necessarily focusing so much on what you would truly need for contrast coding within an actual stats course.
Okay.
So it's not really contrast coding.
Okay.
Okay, and stop this one.